What you gonna do with that
deserto?
In which we're just going to look at our top Kiwi draft picks. This is always fun. Revisiting three unique players each, so we couldn't pick the same player. So, you know, thank God it's the Kiwi Conference, because you're never at a shortage for players that could be right up there. But let's have a look at our 2022 picks, Super Rugby Pacific 2022. And this is, the ranks here are for all players, not just New Zealand. But so, Harry, you picked, Harry obviously got to go first. Nice and simple, picked Richie Moanga, Cody Taylor, and Will Jordan. When in doubt, just go with three Crusaders.
Genius.
Richie Moanga came in at 11th, Cody Taylor at 10, and Will Jordan in third last year. Nels picked Samisoni Takiaho, Salisi Rayasi, and David Havili were your top three picks. Takiaho came in at 4th, Rayasi in at 5, and Havili not so good at 45 overall last year, but that was pretty good. Mm-hmm. And I brought it home with, again, when in doubt, pick the remaining Crusaders. Lester Fayanganuku was 19th. Sevu Reese, very disappointing, at 52. And I picked TJ Perenara, who just didn't rank, I guess. Did he? He did play last year, but...
Mate, TJ, yeah, well, he was injured for a part of it, but mate, he was nowhere on the list that I had, so...
But Nelson, with great, do you want to take us through who some of the top players are? I think you've got that listed in order there for like fantasy players from New Zealand Conference last year.
Yes, this is what Harry's got down, and I like it. My man Tava Tava Nawai, Kurt Eklund, Will Jordan, Takiaho, Rayasi, Nanai Satoru, Jordy Barrett, Brody McAllister, Cody Taylor, Richie Moe, Artie Sevilla, Caleb Clark, Levi Amua, Ray Nuia, D-Mac, Sotutu, Tudge, Thomas Imonga Jensen, Asoakula, Rico, Perifranchise, Scott Gregory, Bowden, Morby, Blackadder, Havili, Roger Tuivasa-Sheck, and Sevilla.
The bus.
Fantastic. So, yes, we haven't obviously previewed the remaining three New Zealand Conference teams yet, but at the end of that podcast for dessert next week, spoilers, we'll pick where we think the teams will rank in the conference. But so this week, without having the knowledge of those three teams and not having discussed the Crusaders yet, let's get through and pick our top three unique players that we think will top fantasy in 2023. And Nelson, you get to go first. We reverse the order.
So we've got... ranks are for all players. Yep. So I got to go. I'm going to go Will Jordan first. I don't care if he has to have rest weeks. He is Will Jordan. Following that, I'm going to go Kurt Eklund. Kurt Eklund is an absolute weapon. He will be a cracker again this year. And then just for the absolute fun of it, I'm going to go a guy that will be in my fantasy team again, Tava Tava Nawai. I just love the man.
So can I just confirm your pick for the 2023 top New Zealanders as 1, 2, and 3 is the exact same as the results from 2022's 1, 2, and 3?
Yeah, I'm not even looking at it, but yes.
Right. Okay. Well, that's fantastic insight. I can see you put deep thought into that.
Look, I mean, I'm
not even looking at it. All right.
Got to go with the guy. But you did, mate.
I can see Kagi already just starting to somehow manifest Takiaho, Rayasi, and Nanai Satoru. But let's throw to him. Who do you think, Craigs? Who do you think?
I think right up there we'll have Lester Fayanganuku. I'm going to back him again. And I made a very difficult decision. I mean, my first draft pick was between Fayanganuku and Sevu Reese, and I picked Sevu Reese, and it did not bode well for me, as you can see, 19th Fayanganuku instead of Sevu Reese, 52nd. I'm going to also pick, this is a simple choice again, but Cody Taylor. I've gone 2 Crusaders, but I just think, look, he's your all-black hooker for 2023.
Nothing players that have passed it, mate, in the fantasy sense, you know, that there has been.
Has been. Really.
Reese last year.
And then I'm going to really disappoint Harry here. Really disappoint him by picking.
I already know where you're going, man. I don't like it.
Who's made a return? D-Mac. There it is. He already started putting it in. I actually had to pick him purely so Harry couldn't. That's, I'll be honest with you. But, hey, I mean, look, he's back. This late. He'll be killing it.
Hey, why are we getting Mwanga all the way back here? This is ridiculous.
Please. All right. So, Nelson, spoilers, mate. This is my turn to shine. Once again, mate, just like Fantasy 2022, I was picking at sixth. And somehow you boys both let me pick Richie Mo as the top fantasy player. My first choice, and he carried me all the way to a championship. Once again, he will be the number one pick for me. And that's, once that's again,
he was injured and he could have been out for 6 weeks.
No, mate, it doesn't matter. You just need to win the other 12 games when he plays. Who cares? Doesn't make a difference. So, Richie Mo, number one, hands down. Don't need to think about it. Cannot believe you let that go through to the keeper. Secondly, I'm going to go with none other than Arti Sevilla, because last year I started to doubt him and I was incredibly wrong, and I'll never doubt him again. And third and final, I think I'm probably going to go for Salisi Reyasi.
Surely you've got to go pair of franchise, mate. Surely you've got to back.
No. Come on, boys. Let's settle down about pair of franchise. 2024 is his year. Salisi Reyasi was so good for the Hurricanes on the wing. I don't know what happened at the back end of his year, why he wasn't just starting for the All Blacks every single week, but watch him do it again. He's going to outscore Fanga and Nuku every single week, and he will be number three, mate. There you go. 1, 2, 3. Two Hurricanes players, so a bit different. Yeah.
It's really interesting, after saying that I picked the top three, you just picked really outlandish picks there, Harry. If we look at the 2022 one as well, you picked the top three across the entire season the year before.
God, I'm good.
Crusaders. Just pick Crusaders. Why are you going Hurricanes players? What are you doing?
You're right, man. Fantastic picks. Don't know how they got to me. I'm with you.
All right. And then, look, let's round out the podcast with some absolute smokies for the 2023 season. From all squads, even the ones we haven't picked yet. So really get your imagination out there. I'm going to kick us off with a guy you might not have heard of, but he's 19 years old, and his name's Peter Lackey. he's my smoky for this year. Man, I hope he sees the game time. But look, just easy pickings on that one for me. Boys, I can see you both struggling to think of someone. Who am I going to throw under the bus first? Nelson, I'll chuck you under the bus, my friend.
Mate, I'm going to stay true, and I think I'm going to have to go for an Aussie. No, none of these Kiwis, mate. This is not how this competition works.
Mate, we've done the Aussies. We literally did this for the Aussies already.
My friend.
I thought you said competition-wide.
No, mate, we did the Smokies for the Aussies and the Aussie fantasy.
Conference-wide, my friend. Is this another stalling tactic? Is this what it is?
He's done well, to be fair.
Yeah.
Oh, can you just iron out the rules for me for a second?
No, mate. You've got all the information you need. New Zealand conference wide, Smokey. Who's going to just come out of nowhere and impress us from the New Zealand conference in 2023 that people don't know?
I am going to go out on
It's like this guy doesn't know his footy or something. You know what I mean?
It's just Smokey as a top player. It didn't have to be someone you don't know.
It's a big name, and he's in a big team, and somehow he's going to get some starts.
Is it Peter Lackey?
Nalani Nanai playing at the Crusaders.
Oh, yeah.
He is on the wing. If that man is in,
down.
That's the man.
Can we all make the gestures? That can be the screenshot, the thumbnail. Just everyone there, settle down. There it is. That's.
Wow. Sit down, mate. How good. Get Nanai on. I hope we get that Twitter account back this year.
And Harry, you've had about 30 years to decide yours, mate. So
yeah, I've made zero headway. Just to clarify, I've made absolutely zero headway in my 30 years that I've had to organise myself. Look, part of me wants to go out with Shannon Frizzell getting a full season. You know, back in the day where he used to just score random 80-point games. So I think that consistent year of him, you might see him just blow the competition away and end up as the top back rower. So he's probably one up there for me. And then other than that, God, I might just say any, no, it's a bit of a cop out, but any Moana Pacifica outside back, just any of them. Does that count?
No, we know them.
Can you find
Ganuku?
You give him a shout out?
No, I'm not going Tima. Anyone but Tima. I don't think it'll be him. God. Stalling unsuccessfully. And I'm going to go one more pick.
It's almost like you guys wanted to pick Peter Lackey or something. You know what I mean? It's
yeah, that's right. I just can't get off him.
Who is counterpart?
Who's the other side? The Chiefs have got to have someone, surely, mate. Well, Nanai Satoru should be a top player, but I think he was not too far away last year, so that's probably not that interesting, not really, is it?
Smoky, my friend.
Braden Yossi, I've got a view, mate. Just put him in.
Yeah, why not? Braden Yossi. Put him in. Lock him in. I like it.
Well done, boys. Well done.
Well, it does panic stations, I'll tell you what.
I realised I forgot to just pick, you know how you pick your top fantasy players? I forgot to just pick both the Ioane brothers, who I always draft into my team every year.
Mate, how the tide has turned.
You hate them.
You hate them.
They're the best. I mean, what else do you need to say? This year, I could possibly get, is it five Ioannis in my team? I could have one third of my team be Ioannis.
Hey guys, can I just finish up? Completely different topic. Oh, you know, there's all this talk about Richie Moe, Bodie Barrett leave the All Blacks next year. And where is this next fly half going to come from? Isn't it just so obviously Stephen Parafranchise and Josh Ioane? Like, they're both so good. They've had a few years to develop. Like, it just has to be them, doesn't it? Like, let's stop pretending like they've got some girth of like missing talent at 10. Those two play a whole Super Rugby season at 10 for their respective franchises. They both kill it, and then they both start in the All Blacks.
And then they're the best 10s in the world.
Yeah. Wow.
Clearly, that's it. The gap that is there is in experience. That's it, not in talent. They are freakish players.
All right. Well, look, I think that's going to round out our first of our two New Zealand conference previews. I think we were a little bit all over the shop in tonight's episode, but super excited. I can tell you that much. And if there's one thing you take out of tonight's episode, it's that Peter Lackey will be the greatest player of 2023.
Tune in 2 weeks' time for the Peter Lackey podcast.
That's it. In 2 weeks' time, we'll have the Peter Lackey podcast. We've talked about him that much. We're going to have to see if we can get him on the podcast. But otherwise, next week, join us back for the second of our two Super Rugby Pacific New Zealand conference previews. And we're going to look at some bum teams like the Crusaders, Moana Pacifica, and the Chefs. So we'll catch you then.
All right.
Ciao.